just going to lighten up some brighter of this nice peach colour in the foreground. If you've missed any of the first videos in this impressionistic acrylic painting, go to my website and you can download an image to work alongside from. This helps to balance out this purple. So at this stage of the painting, I've stepped back from the canvas and had a real look at the painting to see what's working and what's not. There seems to be too many little dotty parts on the painting, so I've decided to block in again with the lilac colour, just so I can get a better feel of a solid area in that mid-ground. This means that when that's got a solid area to it, all the little marks we've got in the foreground and all the marks in the sky on the background will all start to work together a bit better. In this part, I just lighten up the area that's going to be on the horizon line, just so it brings a bit more focus onto that part of the painting. I then redefine this top area of the mountain just so it has a bit more shape to it. I soften the edge just with my finger just to blend it into the existing painting that's already dried off underneath. The same technique that we used at the beginning of this painting, bringing the colours from the sky into the foreground, we use again this way by using colours from the midground into the sky, so it isn't just one solid blue, it's got elements of that purpley hue over on the right hand side. I then add a bit more blue just to blend them in, so it's a bit more of a subtle technique. This lovely powdery blue colour now looks great against that purple we've already put down, and it's just really a balancing act between having a block of colour and then these little flecks of colour that balance together. When you're working with your painting and you keep on stepping back from it and then working forward, there's a bit of a to and a fro between getting something that looks balanced or something that goes too far. The great thing about acrylics is you can just constantly paint over the top, tweaking it until you've got something that just balances to your eye. Again with this brighter yellow mix, I can paint on top of some of the areas that just feel a bit too messy, so I've got a cleaner colour. Notice how that just covers over bits of the green underneath and just looks a lot more solid. I'm trying to draw the viewer's eye around the picture for each colour that I'm using, so it all blends together but has that nice variety on the eye when you're looking at the painting. If you have a close look at my brush, again, you'll see that it's got two different colours on each side. One side's more yellowy, and the other side's more purpley. And when I just paint this next section, I just twist it over, as we did in the first part of this painting, just so you get that mix of colour, that optical mixing happens on the actual canvas, rather than mixing everything on your palette before it goes onto the painting. This helps to give you more of an oil painting technique rather than it look too harsh in the colours that you're using. So I get quite a lot of the white paint onto the brush, but I hesitate when I'm painting because I'm just having such a delicate touch of the canvas when I'm using the brush. I kind of hover over it and just slightly brush the brush against the canvas, so you get those nice little flecks of colour, you get a nice brush mark into your marks. It's handy to do this when you've got a bigger brush making a tinier mark, rather than trying to do it with a smaller brush. You just won't get the same feel to your painting. So I spend a bit of time trying to get the exact colour that I'm after here, because I know it's going to add warmth to the top of the building and just bring a bit of that warmth into the foreground. There are only little marks, but they're the finishing touches onto this painting that just kind of bring it all together. And there we have a very simple impressionistic style landscape. I really hope you've enjoyed this tutorial and learned how Monet used to approach his paintings. This is Will Kemp from Will Kemp Art School.